know, when Queen's lead singer Freddie Mercury died in 1991, he left behind millions of fans and a music legacy that will continue for decades. Here's a bit of a reminder. Show must go on. The show must go on. There you go, Freddie Mercury and Queen. And one man who worked alongside Freddie for the last 12 years, his personal assistant, Peter Freestone, joins us. He's in Australia. He's written a book, and it's a delight to have you with us. Thank you, Peter.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
We just see and remember those wonderful songs and that extraordinary vision of Freddie. What was the difference between Freddie the man and the performer?
It was opposite ends of the scale. Freddie loved being at home behind the walls at Garden Lodge. He could wear trainers, tracksuit, walk in the garden, play with the cats, look at the goldfish, well, carp. Just be himself. Just walk around, have time to think. But as soon as even half a dozen friends come over, Freddie Mercury, the entertainer, appeared. He had to entertain. He had to give people, you know, something special. You, as I say, half a dozen friends or 150,000 people in a stadium. It was Freddie entertaining.
So, as you say, opposite ends. So there was that quirk in his personality. Was he an introvert by nature?
No. I mean, he loved talking with people.
If he had people around him, he could do it. But when he closed down, he was very insular.
No, because even with us in the house, he'd like to have someone there just to talk with, just ordinary things, you know, what we're going to do tomorrow. Just he loved company. He had to have company.
What about, tell me about, as you've written, the first night on the job, as it were, the first day as Freddie's personal assistant. Describe that, that period for us.
Okay. I thought I'd lost my job the first day because what had happened, the three of us went out. After a show, Freddie had to relax. It took him 3-4 hours. You know, the adrenaline, everything. We'd gone out to a bar. Paul Prentice said, I have to go home. I'm not feeling well. You look after Freddie. Just, you know, all you've got to do, pay the bills, get him back to the hotel. You're fine.
What time is it now?
1 o'clock in the morning.
Okay. How long did that process take?
Well, what happened, as soon as Paul went, Freddie started on peppermint schnapps, beer, vodka tonic, peppermint schnapps. I mean, within half an hour, he was a mess. And I really thought, what do I do? He wanted to carry on. He carried on.
And how long did this take during the night?
Oh, well, by 3:30, he was poured into the limousine to get him back home. And I, you know, we got him to his suite, lay him on the bed, thinking, you know, what can I do? There's nothing. I'll stay a little while, make sure he's okay. And then I heard him sort of being sick. And I thought, oh, God, okay, I'll go and get stuff, clean it up. And he just continually, but he was moving round the bed. I thought, okay, I'll be here. He went to sleep, so I went off. I thought, fine, the job's finished. I had to go to the suite in the morning. He's killing himself laughing. And I said to him, but, you know, why were you going round the bed? And he said, well, I was looking for the edge, and it was a round bed. So there was pools of vomit all the way round this bed.
Oh, I should never have gone there.
No.
You are absolutely right. He befriended and had a lot of admirers, people like Elizabeth Taylor.
Yeah. He admired her. She was the epitome of movie star. I remember at the tribute concert after Freddie had died, she gave such a wonderful sort of talk about Freddie. I mean, she admired him, what he stood for. I mean, there's even footage somewhere in America of me holding hands with Elizabeth Taylor, walking through the crowd, which is something wonderful for me.
Mm. As a performer, he was such an extrovert.
Yeah.
The costumes. You look at this, the creation of these videos and everything he did, mm-hmm. was that very much him or created for him?
No, it was, very much him.
He was
very
the instigator?
For almost all the videos,
mm-hmm.
He and the director would sit for a few hours to come up with the ideas. Then the director would make a storyboard, show it to Freddie, and Freddie would change it to suit what he thought would be best for the song.
His other friends, now tell me the story behind, and I now say this with fear and trepidation, the story behind nose, hair and teeth.
That came about from a time when we were in America and they were recording an album, and Rod Stewart came into the studio just to mess around with Freddie in the studio, just sing a few tracks, see what happened. And Elton was around at the same time, and they just came up with this idea. I wish it had happened. It just never did, but they came up with the idea of the hair, the nose, and the teeth, with the hair being Elton, the nose being Rod, and the teeth, obviously, Freddie.
To go on tour together?
Yeah, make an album and go, do it. It should have happened, it really should.
That would have been a lot of fun. Did he enjoy that level of stardom, or did it really scare him?
He wanted to be a star mm-hmm. from the time he started.
Mm-hmm.
He just... that was Freddie.
He loved to dress up.
Oh, yeah.
Didn't he?
Oh, yes.
Was any of that evident at home? At home,
no.
He was sneakers?
No. Mm-hmm. It was just easy clothes. Mm. Put it on.
And he loves shopping, I understand.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he's a man after my
I mean,
heart.
He would go shopping for something for himself, but he would buy something for everybody. He would go for a cologne, he'd buy 5 perfumes and 10 colognes so that the cleaning ladies could have some perfume, mm-hmm. all of us could have something. Well, that was Freddie. He was giving. It was all about giving.
Well, you've written this, but it's not a tell-all biography.
It's an explain a little bit more about. You know, so many people have been asking me, you know, what's Freddie like? What did he do? What didn't he do?
What was his best attribute?
Loyalty to friends.
Worst?
That's got me thinking. Stubbornness.
It is a delight to meet you. And you're in Australia. There's a tribute show, the Queen tribute show as well.
Yeah, I was asked to see the band. It's a Kind of Magic. And the reason that I would endorse them is because they're the nearest I have ever seen to Queen in its heyday.
Well, Peter, thank you. Thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
It's lovely to hear. He was a genius in so many ways
and a
great loss to us. But thank you very much for your time this morning.
No, it's been a pleasure. Thank you.
Peter Freestone joining us on Mornings. More to come on the program. In fact, Becky Cole pops up for a bit of a chat, a song, and also after the break, Dr. Penny answers your email questions. We are the champions.